We are working in workspace 0. Let's open the sources, RX devices. Click here to refresh the sources. Select RTL-SDR. Because we are using RTL-SDR. Now we see RTL-SDR tuner screen and FFT display. We can right click here to organize windows. This will organize windows in columns. Now we need to set frequency to 1090. This is decimation, we need to set it to 1. Now change symbol rate to 2048. RF bandwidth is 2600 kHz. We need to set gain. By default, gain is 0. This is not good because a newbie will never be able to receive anything. So set gain to anything decent. Now click on AGC. Remember, when you click on AGC, gain setting is ineffective. We need to use AGC because ADSB signal is very weak. Click here to open channels. And we need to select ADSB demodulator. Channel includes demodulators and some other stuff. In the demodulator, we do not need to change deviation from the main frequency, keep it 0. However, we need to set threshold to 5. A smaller threshold will have incomplete packets, whereas a threshold value of 10 or more will accept only packets with good signal strength. Here we have avionics databases. The first one is aircraft information. I just updated it. I am not updating the other ones. You can do so on your own. The first part of the screen gives you a lot of information about any aircraft, whereas the second part is the map. On the tuner screen, there are two play buttons. The lower one is only for tuner, whereas the upper one, just below the workspace, is for all modules. If there are more than one modules, right now we only have tuner. But if there are more modules, clicking on this button will start all the modules. On starting the demodulator, we can see the waterfall. It is receiving ADSB signal. We can see two aircrafts. One is from United Airlines and other is from Astana Airline. It has ICAO ID as well as call sign of the flight. It also provides the aircraft type, which we can see is 787-9 for United Airlines. In the next column, we can see country flag. This information is also available if we click on the aircraft. If we double click on an aircraft line, it opens up Plane Spotter's site and shows us the photo of the actual aircraft. This is the photo of the exact aircraft. You can see the registration number. This is from Air Astana. There is a column GS. It shows the ground speed in kiloknots. Set alt column shows the selected altitude in feet. It is receiving signal from another aircraft which belongs to American Airlines. And now we see this aircraft from Air Canada. And this is the photo of the actual aircraft. You can see the tail number, registration number near the tail. Here is a column which shows heading 127. Heading shows the direction in which aircraft is moving. The D column shows the distance of aircraft from the receiving station. This distance is in kilometers. RSSI is received signal strength indicator. Manufacturer of the aircraft is also shown. On the map, we can see Air Canada flight. It shows ICAO number, aircraft which is 777-333ER. We can see the category of aircraft which shows as heavy. There is a column named VR, it's foot per minute. It shows the vertical rate of climb. Negative value mean aircraft is descending. This value is also shown on the map, but in the map, instead of a numerical value, it shows as level flight, which means it is not ascending or descending. And it shows ascending and descending in text. We can see Qatar Airways flight. If you see FFT freezing, it is due to my computer. A continuous line in the FFT on 1090 is not coming from the antenna. It is some sort of problem, and it is from within the system. So you just need to ignore it. If you like spotting planes or receiving communication from the aeroplanes, I will put an aeroplane photo in the community tab of my channel. You can try to guess the photo and answer the question. See you again in another video.